She was a very sweet person, very caring. I always made it my mission to take care of her the best I could.
Jose Cadavid was hundreds of miles away in New York City when he got the tragic news. His younger sister, 35-year-old Blanca Cadavid, had been killed inside this High Point home.
It was such a pain that I couldn't, a pain that I never felt before. I was so heartbroken and I was angry, depressed, sad.
An hours-long standoff last week between Josue Drummond Cruz and police came to an end when officers returned fire, killing him. Inside the house, they found Cadavid's body and two children alive and unharmed.
Unfortunately, they saw everything what happened inside the house with the police shootouts and everything. I don't think it has hit them yet, the loss of both of their parents.
Jose says Drummond Cruz was his sister's boyfriend, the father of her children. He described their relationship as toxic, a long cycle of domestic violence. A relationship, he tells me, he tried to help Blanca leave.
Whenever he would use drugs or get drunk, he would hit my sister. She's the type of person, no matter what, she still loves you and she forgives you. And that's what she did. She kept going back to him too, because she loved him and she always forgave him.
As an NYPD officer himself, he's responded to many difficult calls.
This is when it hits home, when it's your own personal family that it happens to, it's just, you're not prepared for it.
Not prepared for the unexpected loss, not prepared to say goodbye to her kind heart and sweet soul. In High Point, Alma McCarty, WFMY News 2.